How do we see microbes? What do they look like? As always, here's your list of new words for today. You should have learned them in previous classes, but if not, then I guess they're new to you. Light microscope, compound microscope, objective lens, ocular lens, condenser lens, fluorescent microscopy, phase contrast microscopy, dark field microscopy, transmission electron microscope, scanning electron microscope, cocci, bacilli, spirilla, diplo, staphylo, and strepto. As you've learned previously, Anton van Leeuwenhoek holds the title of father of microscopy. His glass grinding methods were so fine that he was able to actually see bacteria. Of course, they were not known back in the late 1600s as bacteria. Rather, Leeuwenhoek described them as little animalcules. You can see in this picture Leeuwenhoek's microscope, which is pretty crude. But as I said, he was so good at grinding glass and making lenses that he was able to get a really high magnification. Given that his microscope had just one lens, it's pretty incredible that he could see bacteria at all. Though Anton really began the development of the modern microscope, people have been trying to magnify stuff for years. Leeuwenhoek wrote more than 375 letters to the Royal Society of London describing his microscopic observations. In one, he wrote, "I've had several gentlewomen in my house who were keen on seeing the little eels in vinegar, but some of them were so disgusted at the spectacle that they vowed they'd never use vinegar again. But what if one should tell such people in the future that there were more animals living in the scum on the teeth in a man's mouth than there are men in the whole kingdom, especially in those who don't ever clean their teeth? For my part, I judge that all the people living in our United Netherlands are not as many as the living animals I carry in my mouth this very day." No one knows who first figured it out, but quite a long time ago, someone picked up a crystal that was thicker in the middle than it was at the edges. When they looked through, they realized that it made things appear larger. Someone also realized that such a crystal could focus the sun's rays and set fire to a piece of parchment or cloth. Magnifiers and burning glasses, or magnifying glasses, are mentioned in the writings of Pliny the Elder, a Roman philosopher during the 1st century AD. Apparently, they were not used much until the invention of spectacles towards the end of the 13th century. They were named lenses because they were shaped like the seeds of a lentil. The earliest simple microscope was merely a tube with a plate for the object at one end, and at the other a lens which gave a magnification. But the magnification was not so great. It was usually less than 10 times the original size, so more like the dissecting microscopes we would see today. Still, people had a fun time looking at organisms that were already visible to the naked eye. In particular, flies and fleas were observed up close, and so these simple microscopes were often called flea glasses. So if you look at these pictures, the bottom picture is of a flea at 10x magnification. In about 1590, two Dutch spectacle makers, Zacharias Janssen and his son Hans, started experimenting with multiple lenses in a single tube. They realized that nearby objects appeared greatly enlarged. This was the forerunner of the compound microscope and the telescope. Galileo heard of their work and worked out the principles of the lenses. He was then able to make a much better instrument with a focusing device. So Galileo sort of worked out the math, and based on that, he was able to figure out how to get a better magnification. Galileo held many titles. The father of astronomy, the father of modern physics, the father of science. He did a lot. But for our purposes, his main contribution was refining the concepts of magnifying lenses. Robert Hooke started playing around with microscopes and confirmed Anton van Leeuwenhoek's discoveries of tiny organisms in a drop of water. Hooke then improved upon Leeuwenhoek's design. It actually took some time to improve the microscope further, and it was not until the middle of the 19th century when Charles Spencer was reputed to make the finest microscopes in the land. It was then that compound microscopes began to form. Today we have all sorts of microscopes for a variety of different purposes. In general, using a compound light microscope at 1,000 times magnification is perfect for viewing bacteria. But there are other kinds that are useful, depending on the information we need. Most microscopes that you will find in a lab look like this one. There are essentially two main lenses, the ocular lens, which is the one that you look through, and the objective lens, which is the one that's closer to the specimen. Both lenses provide magnification to the object that is placed on the stage. Most of the time, the ocular lens alone will have a 10x magnification on it. That means if you took the ocular off and looked at something, it would appear 10 times larger than it actually is. Here's a picture of a $1 bill under 10x magnification. Most handheld magnifying glasses that you can get today at a drugstore can offer 10x.